Welcome to the Accessibility Guy channel. Today we're going to be talking about applying lists in Microsoft Word. Now I always approach these topics from an accessibility perspective, so you'll know that after you follow most of what we go over in this video, that your lists are also going to be accessible for a screen reader. So let's dive right in. I have a document here that has some sample list items on it. The first element that we see is some text called structural hierarchy. I want to very quickly add in a heading level here so that we can chunk our content a little bit better. So I'm going to name this headings, and then I'm going to quickly apply a heading level 1. Now the very next item that I have is a number 1 called structure hierarchy. I know that a list item is already applied because from the home tab underneath the paragraph options, I have the numbered list element selected. If I deselect it, it will remove the number 1, and it will also apply some visual spacing between the words. If I select it again, it will apply a number 1, but it also nests the list slightly different. So if I want to back this list item out, I'm going to use the decrease indent button a couple of times. This will pull my content all the way back to the left side where I want it. Now, I have another list item called heading order is an outline, and it's set to a 1 also. The best way that I can get this item to show as a number 2 is I need to get it on the same level as this other item 1. To do that, I'm going to decrease the indent, and then I'm going to right click the number itself, and I'm going to select continue numbering. This will ensure that my list items are going in the right order. And if I wanted to add an additional item, like let's say I wanted to add a number 3, I could hit the enter key at the end of this paragraph a couple of times, type the number 3 and the space bar, and it will auto format this list item. I can then add an additional list item. Let's say that I wanted to change the way some of these bulleted list items look. I'm going to select these 3 bulleted list items, and I'm going to go up to the bulleted list element, and we can actually choose a different looking list item. This will apply a different structure to this content, but it's still going to be completely accessible. And whenever a screen reader runs into this content, it's not going to have any problem with reading it. Let's move down a little bit. I'm going to apply a couple of different heading structures here since we're in our document. And next, I want to move all of these list items over just one notch to the left. And let's say I needed to add some additional content between these two list items. And let's just say this was a completely different heading level. I would need to start this list over. Now I can do that by simply selecting the list item, right clicking, and I'm going to select restart at 1 to restart that list. It's important for list items to be a number if the order is important, but if the order is not important, like the list I have at the bottom of this page, then we can go ahead and use bulleted lists. Let's say you wanted to add a multi-level list to your document. In this example, I have several already, but let's just pretend that I wanted to add some additional content to this bullet under remove photo of or picture of. I could hit the enter key and press tab on my keyboard, and this will add another nested list item or a multi-level list. And just for fun, if I wanted to add another item, I could simply press the enter key again and keep adding additional list items. So you just learned how to apply list items to your Microsoft Word document. Thank you for watching.